everyone. Welcome back to integralcalc.com. Today we're going to be talking about how to find the derivative of a linear combination. And it sounds really complicated, but it's not. Basically, the formula that we're going to be using here is the following. And all it says is that when you're taking the derivative of some function, f of x, and it's multiplied by a constant real number, a, like this, you're taking the derivative of that whole thing, you can just factor out the a, you bring it out in front here, and you can ignore that for the purposes of the derivative and just take the derivative of the function f of x, and multiplying them together, a times f of x will be the final answer for the derivative. So pretty easy. Let's just look at a couple examples. We've got 5x to the fourth. What it's saying here is that a is 5, because that's the constant real number that's the coefficient on this x to the fourth term. So we've got a, and f of x is this x to the fourth here. So if we want to take the derivative of 5x to the fourth, this formula for the derivative of a linear combination tells us that we can bring the 5 out in front and just find the derivative of x to the fourth, right? We just take the derivative of x to the fourth. Now it's a matter of just using power rule to find the derivative of x to the fourth. So remember that to find the derivative of x to the fourth, we just multiply this coefficient out in front. So we bring the 4 down in front, and then we leave the variable there, x, and subtract 1 from the exponent. So 4 minus 1 is 3. And if we simplify this by multiplying by the constant a, which we factored out, 5 times 4 is 20, so we end up with 20x cubed. So that's all it's saying. Now let's just take a look at a couple more examples to make sure we understand. So again, negative 6 will be a, and f of x is just going to be this x term here. So we can factor out the negative 6 and just take the derivative of x. Well, the derivative of x is just 1. So we end up with negative 6 times 1, which of course just simplifies to negative 6. If we look at 90 times x to, raised to the 100, we can factor out the 90 because this part right here is a, according to our formula, and this x to the 100 here is f of x. So if we factor out the 90 and we multiply by the derivative of x raised to the power of 100, we leave this 90 out in front. Remember, to find the derivative of x to the 100, we'll bring the exponent out in front, so we get 100 out in front, leave the variable x, and then subtract 1 from the exponent, so 100 minus 1 is 99. So that's the derivative of x to the 100, and then we just multiply together here, this 90 times 100, which gives us 9,000. So we end up with a final answer of 9,000 x to the 99. So that's it. That's all this formula tells us in terms of how to find the derivative of a linear combination, and you can do this with polynomials. So for example, if you had these added together, if your problem was 90 x to the 100 plus the first example we did, 5x to the 4, you could do these one at a time, take the derivative of this first term and then the derivative of the second term and just add them together. So you would end up with, if we bring our answer down here, you would end up with 9,000 x to the 99 plus 20x cubed, and that would be your final answer for this problem. So you can use it with polynomials. You just apply it to one term at a time. So that's it. I hope this video helped you guys, and I will see you in the next one.